Hi there, it's Dan from Mercedes-Benz of Zaffend, and this is the Hanover video for the Mercedes EQA. Please bear in mind it's just a demonstrator, so the trim may vary from your own car. So first of all, to get the car started up, just pop your foot on the brake, hit the start button round to the left-hand side. When the car switched on, it will say vehicle ready to drive, and it will say ready down here next to the gears. To select drive, put your foot on the brake, and then push down on the right stalk for drive. You see it changes there, handbrake comes off by itself. Push up for reverse, your camera comes on, and then push the button on the end to put it in park. The handbrake on the car is automatic, so you've got the button for it down here, to the right of the steering wheel. So as long as you put it into gear, the handbrake comes off by itself. Otherwise, when you turn the car off or open your door, you see the handbrake goes back on by itself there. The headlights on the car are automatic, so you can either style where it is like so. You've also got the rear fog light button there and the dimmer switch for the dash lighting, like so. For your high beams, push away on the left stalk, and when you do, the symbol comes up on the bottom for automatic. Basically, the EQA has active high beam assist, so it will activate the main beams when necessary, whether it's dark enough or whether there's no cars coming. Turn it off again, push away on the left stalk again, and the symbol goes away like so. To flash somebody, just pull back on the stalk. For your wipers, on the end of the stalk here, you can twist it around for your different wiper speeds. The two dotted ones are automatic, and the top two are constant. The further around you go, the faster the wipers go. You've also got the front washers on the end button here. If you push it lightly, you also do a single wipe. And then you've got the rear wiper and washers on here as well. Again, if you push this button lightly, you get a single wipe on the rear. On the driver's door card, you've got your usual buttons. So you've got the door lock overrides here, you've got the window switches and the rear window child lock. Then you've got the mirror adjustment down here. You've also got the button in the middle to fold the mirrors in. To adjust your mirrors, select a side like so, and then just adjust it on the pad to change the mirror. And then above that, you've also got the heated seats, again on both sides. Next we come to the steering wheel. You've got two touch control buttons on each side. These three buttons here control the left screen, and then these three buttons here control the right screen. So you can scroll left and right, up and down on each of the screens. You can click the button to go in, push the back button to go back, and you can push the home button to go back to the home screen like so. Then below that on the left side, you've got the phone controls here. You've got a volume wheel, so you can move up and down for the volume and push it into mute. Bottom right one, flick it down, there's a little star button. This takes you to your shortcuts menu. We can go in and create shortcuts to anything in the system. And then push up is the manual override for the voice control. Now, of course, on this car with the manual voice control override button here, you don't have to do that. You can also just use your voice itself. So if you just say, "Hey, Mercedes," "How can I help?" and the voice assistant comes on, you can hear she's listening to me here. You can ask anything you like, from changing the radio station, putting on your heated seat, setting the sat nav, anything you can think of, really. You can even ask her to tell you a joke. Then on the right-hand side again, these three buttons at the top do the instrument cluster. So if I zoom out there, you can scroll up and down on the middle screen, for example. You can swipe to the right and adjust this screen. All the different options you can see up here to go through. And again, swipe to the left and go up and down on this dial as well. If you push the home button, it gives you the menu. So currently I'm on the trip screen in the middle. You can go to radio, so it gives you the radio in the middle there. Push home again. You can go to navigation and get a map in the middle, and so on and so forth. And then below that you have the cruise control and speed limiter. So you push up for cruise control, it shows you the little symbol up there on the dash, and push down on the button for limiter. As you can see, it comes up at the top. So up for limit, cruise control, down for limiter. You set it by pushing the middle button up or down. It will set it on the screen. Up at the top in green there, you can adjust it up or down in ones or with double click, like so. If you can see that, one, two clicks, it goes up in fives as well. So you can see we're on 30, double click it, goes on to 35. If you want to cancel, push downwards and reset puts it back onto the previous amount you had it on. So next thing I'll show you is the actual driving styles of the car. So when the car's in drive, you see it's in drive there, ready to drive, the car can be driven straight away as long as you've got ready on the screen. Now on this car, different levels of recuperation in terms of regaining energy into the batteries. So when you're driving along, the D symbol there, obviously there's no gears in this car, so instead it shows you the recuperation on the car. If you pull and hold the paddles on the car, either one, I'll pull the plus one for now, it goes into D auto. So D auto is the automatic mode for the regeneration on the car. So this basically means the car will brake using the motor on the car to regain energy rather than using the actual brake pads and discs. So automatic is the main mode where it will do it all for you. It will figure out the best way, whether it wants to coast, whether to recuperate energy at any given time. If you pull the plus paddle, you see it goes into D plus mode. D plus means that the car will roll more, it will coast more easily, and you won't do any recuperation on the brakes. Pull the minus paddle, it goes back into D. This is the normal recuperation status of the car. Pull again on the minus, you go into D minus. This gives you a little bit more recuperation on the brakes. So basically, you don't have to do any sort of braking yourself. It will actually stop a little bit for you. And pull it one more time on the minus, you get D minus minus, which is the maximum possible regeneration on the car. So pretty much you can do one pedal driving on this mode. So if you lift off the throttle, the car will brake heavily using the electric motor to recuperate energy. And to get it back to how you had it in the first place, again, put and hold either paddle and it'll go back to D auto mode. Next, we'll show you the overhead panel. Simple things here, just the interior light controls and everything. You've got the Mercedes Me button here, which is Mercedes Me Concierge. Basically, if you have any queries about the car or any questions, or if you require a breakdown, hit this button, it'll go through to the contact centre for you. And then if an emergencies are required, whether it's police, fire or ambulance, hit the SOS button underneath here to call them. Next, we have the climate control system. So on each side, you've got the temperature control for both driver and passenger. On the left-hand side, you've got the menu button. This takes you to the menu on the touchscreen, so you can control everything about the climate control from the touchscreen itself. You've got the fan speed here, automatic button, which does everything for you. You've got the front and rear demister. In the middle, you've got the hazard warning light switch there. You've got the recirculation, aircon toggle, and then the air button is for the pre-entry climate control. This basically means you can get into the car without turning it on, push this button and it will set the car's temperature, and you can just set it on the end dials and you can heat or cool the car without turning it on in a way. Next, we'll show you the main control area of the car. So around the outside of the touchpad, we've got a few buttons here to go through. First of all, you've got another volume wheel here, same as the one on the steering wheel. You can roll it up or down or push it in to mute it. You've got a shortcut for navigation, radio and Bluetooth. You can just toggle between the two by keep pushing it. You've got the button for the phone to go into your telephone, Bluetooth there. Another star button, again, like the one on the steering wheel here, to go to the shortcuts menu. Again, you can set shortcuts to anywhere in the system. Above that, you've got a picture of the car. This is for the car settings, which I'll cover later on. The one above that is for the active parking assist, the Parktronic. So to use that, I'll just show you what happens next. So when you push this button, you get this one come up on the screen. So it basically says drive forward to search for a parking space. So make sure you're in drive and drive forward. When you go past the spaces, they'll start to appear on behind the car on the screen here on the right hand side. When it's found a space that's suitable, it will come up outlined on the screen and it will bong at you with a little P inside the box. When you get that P, stop the car, click the touchpad to accept it, then pop the car into reverse, and then you're ready to go. Simply let it go of the controls and the car will park itself. Obviously, just cover the brake pedal at all times, just in case, because obviously you're still in control of the car, but the car will effectively park itself. If you need to stop it at any time, just grab the steering wheel or just put the car back into park and it will cancel it. And then the next button to show you is Dynamic Select. So this is basically the driving mode of the car. So by default, you're in blue C there for comfort mode. If you flick the switch down, you go into E for eco mode. If you flick it up above comfort, you go into sport mode. This basically makes the car more sharper and everything on the throttle response and the steering. In eco mode, the car will basically make it harder to go quicker. So as you can see there, the speed is limited a little bit. So you'll get a little bit of feedback on the pedal when you push it down on the throttle. It'll make it harder to push it down as far as you normally would. So just make it a little bit easier to drive the car more economically. And then if you put it down from eco, there's nothing there. That's the final one on that list. Push it up above sport and you've got individual, which basically means you can go into the little cog there and you can customize it to your own custom settings. Next, we'll show you the touchpad on the car. So it's like a laptop one. You can just swipe left or right, up and down to move around on the system. Same thing with the little touch control button on the left here. Up or down, left and right, and you click on it to go forward. You've got the back button to go back. And again, another home button to go back to the home screen. On the top middle, you've got a little skip button here. This basically means wherever you are on the system, say for example you're in the sat nav, if you push this button, you can change between radio stations on the fly. So if we go onto the radio there, like so, go on to navigation, and then push the button, I can switch between stations using the touchpad just by swiping across. Now we come to the screen itself. So this is of course a touch screen, so you can use your fingers to move around on the system if you want to. Just tap to go into things. First thing we'll do is set a profile up for yourself. So go onto the profile thing at the top right, go on to create a profile. This is where we do it. So select a profile silhouette for yourself. Enter your name, hit OK. Leave it on current settings, don't do factory. The next screen is suggestions, so make sure you turn this on and accept. This basically means the car will remember some of the things you do and recommend them back to you over time. Hit continue. If you want to, you can set a home address. So hit enter address. Type in a postcode. No need for spaces. Hit OK. Tap on the result. And hit a tick to save it, and you're all good to go. Then hit continue. And then pair up your phone. This is the final part. So go into connect phone. Make sure you go into the Bluetooth screen on your phone itself. Go onto the Bluetooth list. Make sure your device is visible to other cars and stuff. When the device appears on this list here, just tap on it. Then follow the prompts on your phone to get it paired up to the car. Then when you're done, hit finish and you're good to go. Next on the car, we'll show you the navigation screen. So basically the EQ8 has EQ-based navigation. So if you set a route on the car and it's further than the car can go, it will set a route via the nearest charging stations on the way. Normally, if you go into the settings, you can make it so that the car either goes until it's either 25% left on the battery or down towards 10% until it needs to get to a charging station. So you can set it towards your liking, how you'd like it to get to the nearest station on the nav in the settings. So otherwise, to zoom in and out on the map, you can pinch in and out like so with your fingers. You can also do this on the touchpad, like so. On the left-hand side, you've got a little 2D thing here. You can change the orientation. So you've got 2D map, north-facing, and 3D map, which faces down a little bit, and you get the sky. On here, you've got a button for searching for nearest charging stations as well. Nice and simple. As well as just a regular button for nearest parking. Down the bottom, you've got your where to button. So same as I did before for the home address. Just type your postcode in to get your address. You've also got previous destinations, favourites, and points of interest. Again, up there is EV charging stations. Nice and easy to find. Down below there, you've also got the cancel route button. This one here does the mute. This one is a route overview. And then you also got the navigation settings. Make sure you go into this at some point. Go into the advanced area. Make sure you change it all to your liking. And make sure when you go into the settings as well, click on the little cog like so. Make sure you turn on range. This basically means when you zoom out on the map, if I zoom out far enough, put it on north facing, like so. And I just wait for it to load. So as you can see, zooming out on the map here now, this little bubble on the map shows me the range on this car. So it just gives you a really nice visual representation of exactly how far you can drive on this car at any given time. Really nice little tool, that. Next, we'll go through the radio on the car. So when you click into it, you can swipe left and right in the usual sort of way on the screen with your finger. If you click on the touchpad, it also gives you the station list. You can also use this button down here. You can swipe for the stations just so you can browse through them all without actually interrupting what you're listening to. And then when you found the one you want, just click on it, like so. You can save stations by clicking the pluses. And if you want to amend it, just push and hold, and you can move it or delete it. Again, there's also a station search down the bottom. You've got the mute button there, and also the radio settings. Now again, you've got all your equalizer settings here, but make sure you go into general at some point, go into radio text information and turn this on. This basically means you'll see text underneath the station name here. Next, we'll show you the EQ screen. So this is quite a neat little screen. You can go through some of the options in terms of charging options for the car. So you can go onto there and search for charging stations again on here. You can set the departure time for the car. So this is like a weekly profile for the climate control, for the pre-entry climate control. So it's quite a handy little idea. You can click the settings where are we? Go on to week profile, edit the one I'm on. I've already done this through the Mercedes Me app, but you can actually choose the times that you want the car to start the pre-entry climate control at any given time. So you can edit it all in there. You've also got charging programs. You can set the standard one. I just use this one. So you've got the different times that the car will charge if plugged in, and the maximum start charge state it will charge to. But you can also set different ones. So you can have a home one, a work one as well. The next screen is for consumption. So this basically tells you your miles per kilowatt hours, and also it divides it up, shows you what exactly is using that power, which is quite a cool little idea. There's also a little graph here as well, and the last 30 minutes. So you can change on there the different time frames it looks at. Then the next screen on there is energy flow. So this basically shows you when you're driving along. If I just pull forward a little bit and drive, so you can just see where the power's coming from. If I brake, it just shows it charging there, going into the car. Hard to do it on the spot there, but you get the idea. So basically, this graph shows you the power consumption going towards the batteries, towards the motor, going to the wheels, and if you're charging, essentially it goes back from the wheels into the motor, back to the batteries. So it just shows you where the power flow is going around the car at any given time, and also a nice representation of the percentage left in your battery. If the fuel gauge, if you like, isn't enough, you can also see it as a nice representation on here as well. And then the final screen I'll show you is the car settings. When you go into here, the first one you'll get is the quick access menu. So on here you've got a button for the ESP. This is basically for the stability program. Just leave this turned on at all times where you can. This button here is to turn off the parking assist. So for example, you're parking in a tight spot and you know what you're doing and the sensors are going mad, you want to just turn them off. Just hit this button here and that'll turn off the parking sensors for you. As a little secret, if you go into the self-parking button, there's also a little shortcut to do it up here as well. Quite handy. And then below that, you've got the button here. This is for the active lane keep assist. So basically, when you're driving along, the car, if you go over like a solid white line, like a dash white line, the car will sort of vibrate the wheel if you're starting to get close to it. And then if you go over it without indicating, sort of like you're drifting over it, like you're falling asleep, the car will actually brake and pull you back in again. So if you don't like this, just turn it off on the button like so. And then to the right of that, you've got this one here for the tow-away protection. So basically that means if the car's put in a trailer or anything, if it's towed away, it will set the alarm off because it knows it's being nicked or anything like that. So if you've got like a ferry or anything, or you put the car on a trailer yourself and you actually are doing it, it's not being nicked, just turn this off to stop the alarm being tripped. And then same thing again here, you've got the interior motion sensor. So if you leave like a dog in the car or children, for example, just turn this off before you get out, just to stop the alarm being tripped on the inside of the car. And then the final one there is car wash mode. So basically, if you turn this on, the car will be turned into the optimum settings for a car wash. So for example, it will fold the mirrors in, it will turn off the automatic wipers, just things like that, just to stop the car being sort of damaged in a car wash, for example. And then the next screen on there is assistance. So on here, you basically got all the little niggly settings for the assist on the car. You can change everything all to your own liking. You can turn off the active lane keep assist, so you can make it more sensitive if you want to. Active brake assist, again, you can change the settings on that, how extensive you want it to be. And also, if you don't want it turned on, you can also turn off the blind spot assist as well, with the little triangles, if you can just about see them in the mirror there. If you don't like it, you can turn it off through here. And then the next menu is for vehicle settings. So in here, you can change things like the acoustic lock, for example. This is the one that basically means the car will toot the horn when you lock it. So if you want to turn it on, just click it to turn it on like so. Then you've got the obvious ones, automatic locking, so it locks the doors when you drive away, and the auto-folding mirrors, and then the option there to remind you that when you're low on electricity, to automatically search for charging stations. And then the next menu is for lighting. So in here you can change the ambient lighting settings. If you go into ambient lighting, you can change the colour. I've currently got it on the default, which is the red moon lighting, so you've got the red and blue mix, which looks really, really nice. Especially in the dark garage here, you can see it really nicely. So you've got all the different multicolour themes on there. If you turn off multicolour, you can change it to anything from the 64 colour range. So you can see you've got all blue. You've also got the effects. So you've got the welcome effect, which basically means it sort of cycles through the different colours when you get into the car. And you've also got climate mode. So if you turn the temperature up, the lights go red. And if you turn it down, they go blue. You've also got charging, so I think it means that the lights in the car sort of glow like red and green if the car is charging or finished charging, for example. And again, you've also got the brightness, so you can change the different brightness zones, the different areas on the car. You can change how bright they are in terms of just these strips or just the vents. You can change them all separately here if you turn this on. Otherwise, you can just change it all at the same time, up to any brightness you like. And then the next option on there is the exterior light delay switch off. This is how long it takes for the lights to turn off when you get out of the car and walk away and lock it. So you can set it between anything on 0, 15, 30, 45 and 60 seconds. You've also got the option to turn on the interior lighting so it goes off in the same time frame. And then you've also got the button for the surround lighting. So when you unlock it at night, it will shine around the car to make it look nice and pretty like so. And then finally, we have the system settings. So if you go into here, the top one you get up there is... The top one on there is styles and display. So if you go into styles and display, like so, this is where you can change the different themes on the car. So at the minute we're on the sport themes. You've also got the classic theme, like so, and progressive, which is like a more futuristic one. So you can see it changes the entire theme on the car. Put it back into sport. You can also change the control settings. You can change the sensitivity of the touch controls, for example. And you've also got things like time and date settings, units, and various other things on there as well. So there you go, that's the basic controls of the EQA for you. If you have any further questions, feel free to ask us. Otherwise, enjoy your new car.